Hello guys, today we're going to place the back piece of the stern. It's the base, of course, for the officer's quarters. As you can see, I have the piece in water soaking, because in the previous video, if you remember, here we have a curve, so the piece needed to be bent. So I'm going to bend it a little. Doesn't need much, but it's a big surface, so it's not easy. I have made a couple of marks here and here where it needs to be bent. Also, as you can see, the piece has a base. Right here, so I'm not able to make a mistake and place it the wrong way, or more to the left or more to the right. Just I need to make it a little curved. So let me adjust the tripod and I'll get back to you to curve the piece. Now guys, this is a piece. Let's see how to bend it. I will try it this way, because on this way it might be difficult. Now this way. Let me get the piece wet. Already I have a small curve, as you can see, but it's very small. Let me try the other end. I do not need much of a curve, because the piece is big, so I'll be able to bend it, but I want it to stay there and not use too many pins to hold it in position, because this piece will be glued in white glue. Must be careful of my fingers not to get burned. I believe it needs a little more. If I can bend it a little more, it will be Let's try. It's very hard because the piece is very big. I'm definitely going to need pins to hold it in position. There's no doubt about that. Now, I'm going to let the piece dry and I'll get back to you with the procedure of the placement. Now guys, waiting for the piece to dry, let me show you something that will help you. As you can see, the piece will go like this. So, I have to bend it and put some pins so it can hold it in place until the glue is dry, because I'm going to use only white glue. As you can see here, it's not a square. This, the base, it's wider than the upper part. So what I have done, it's I drew two lines here, and these lines are represent the part when I can insert my pins. The inside of the piece is a little burned. We do not care, because first of all no one can see it, and the upper part I started to sanding down, but I discovered in a photo that it will be covered, so there's no need to do that either. Now, white glue. Apply white glue. Let's check first of all where the piece will be attached. Okay, in every single surface that I can see. So, white glue here. Don't worry about wiping off the excess glue, you can do it after. Anyway, this glue will be transparent after it dries, so there's no problem at all if you don't wipe it off, as long as it's not too much. Now, let's place the piece. Already have the pins in hand. It's moments like that that I wish I had three hands. Let me get the glue off my hands. might get it here. It's very difficult. I wish I had an extra hand. Let's do it at the bottom first. Now, let's put some more pins just to be sure. Just wipe off some of the white glue on the inside. From this side it's okay. Let me check the other side. It's okay over here too. So guys, let me remove the camera from the tripod. As you can see, here at the deck we have a perfect match. Also at this side, just have to wipe the glue over here. And also at this side. So I have to wipe the glue down here, let the piece dry, and cover all this back with some wood strips. Sand it down, and we're okay for the next step, which is this. At the bow we will cover it, as I can see, with some pieces of walnut. So guys, I'm up to the next step, and I have cut already the pieces in length. Make sure before you do any work that you have measured correctly and have all the pieces cut in the same length. I estimate I'm going to use 18 pieces, maybe a couple of more or maybe a couple of less. I will see, but for now I have cut all this. Now let me get the camera on a tripod and show you how to place them. Now guys, as you can see, I have placed just one piece. According to the plans, after I have to place three pieces here, everything is 40 millimeters in length. Then I will have to place another three pieces here, and again over these three another three, so I have 3 plus 3 plus 3, 9 pieces per side, and I will have an extension of 2 millimeters because of the thickness from here all the way to here. Of course, as you realize, you have to sand it down. Now the pieces requires very small bending, like you see here. Nothing too serious. because like if you remember when we were fixing the keel, this was a very big curve. Now it's a perfect match, as you can see, and to apply it only with cyano acrylic glue. Easy. Now let's place another one. Again, cyano acrylic glue. That's it. Exactly the same procedure for the rest of the 3 and 3/6 pieces, and exactly the same procedure for the other side. So let me place the pieces and I'll get back to you with the finishing result. As you can see, guys, it looks a little bit ugly because it needs a lot of sanding, and of course right here it needs to be smooth, but I will do that after I finish the other side as well. Like I said, it's very easy, just a small bend, and the secret to this point is to make sure that every piece has the same exact length as the other before gluing. So I will finish the other side, I will sand it down, and I'll get back to you. Look at that, guys, sanded down, the edges rounded up, perfect. Now let's move on with the next step. Now guys, continuing to fixing the bow. As you can see, we have to place these little strips here, and in between of these strips we have to place these strips here. The strips for the yellow wood is this one, is 2x2. It's a very soft wood, and it will be easy to bend, but it will need definitely sanding down after the bending, not before, because we're going to have burn marks. Now let me get the camera on a tripod and I'll get back to you. Now guys, I have bended the piece. As you can see, I have sanded down from the inside, so now the burn marks will be eliminated, and now I have to place it like this. I have to place it in this curve at the edge. Don't mind going over the edge over here at the top, because I will cut it down later. I just have to place it right here. Doesn't matter that the curve does not match the curve of the bow, because the wood is very, very flexible, so I can put it wherever I wish. Now I have to keep these holes uncovered, so the angle must be like this. Let me place the piece. I will start from here, and Now I can continue to the top, just apply some glue. The first piece is glued. So what I have to do is place now a couple of these right here, and then I will place the second piece. But before doing that, I must measure and cut the boards, the wood strips, accordingly to this angle. I must make it to be perfect. That's a bit easy. As you can see, it's almost done. Just some sanding down and it will be a perfect match. Now, let me cut it in the appropriate length and I'll get back to you. Now I have the piece. Let me show you something. As you can see here, let me get focus right here. As you can see, it has an angle right here, and over there at this edge it's curved. I make it smooth. Also at the back of this piece, as you can see, it has some angle too, but it's a perfect match right there. So let's glue. I will cover up the holes, but I will open them, of course, before I move on to the other side. Now, I have to put another one like this, and I'm ready to place the underneath piece. So let me cut it again and I'll get back to you. Second piece ready. Let's glue. Ready. Now, let me cut in the appropriate length and bend this piece, and I'll get back to you with the gluing. This is the piece I've bended. Now, let's vanish the burns with some sandpaper. As you can see, I keep my finger at the back for some resistance to do not break the piece. Now, all I have to do is place it over there. Let's glue. I've made a little mark here. ready. Everything needs sanding down, of course, but that's easy. Now, I will repeat the procedure. Again, I will place another two right here and another piece underneath, and I'll get back to you. So guys, one side is almost ready. I had to cut down here the wood because I saw the plans that there was a line that was going down here, and I was probably 3 millimeters over here, so the top, the lower piece, this one, will be over here, so I will have a strange curve, and it wasn't nice. Everything, all the stamps from the glue will be vanished when I apply the first coat of varnish, so nothing to worry about. Now, what we have to do is to open up the holes. Here there are 2 holes. You can see them over here. Now, let me get my drill, let me place the camera on a tripod, and I'll get back to you. Now guys, I'm going to use a 2 millimeter drill tip, and I will eat up the wood, just making a few holes. Now, let me, because I have to turn the ship, let me adjust the tripod. As you can see, the holes are there. Now, all I have to do is eat up just a little any excess wood and make it like it should be. I see here I had a little accident, I will show you, but nothing to worry about, I can fix it easily. Right here, the wood has unglued and gone, but I will place a small piece, I will glue it right here, and I will sand it down, nothing serious. Now, I'm going to fix this, I'm going to make the other side as well, and I will show you the finishing product. Now guys, both sides complete, sanded down, and I tried to do it to be a match. As you can see here, both wood strips end at the same height. All the wood strips end at the same height. It's getting very, very beautiful. Now, I have to place the number 60 at the front deck. So, let's do that, and that's the end for this video. Let me get ready and I'll get back to you. Now guys, the last step needs to place these two. They're prefixed by Okre. What I have to do is to drill 2 3 millimeter holes in each of the pieces, and a little sanding, nothing too serious. Now, these are the plans. Here are the piece, the one piece, here is the other. As you can see, almost half of the piece is at the edge and above the edge of the curve of the bow. This means let me get the model right. This means that the piece must go exactly here at the edge. Exactly here. I will use some white glue. I don't want to use cyanoacrylic because maybe I need some adjustments and the surface is completely flat in each and every one. So if I use cyanoacrylic and I put it, I placed it in the wrong place, I'll be in a big problem. Now apply some glue. Doesn't need much. Now, let's compare. As you can see, here we have almost half the piece off the edge of the deck. Also here, almost half the piece is off the edge. It's almost exactly at the edge of the deck. Same thing to the other side. Let me get the ship right. Now, that's it, guys. This was almost too easy, but the rest were difficult. Thanks again for watching. See you with the next step, which I believe is placing the rails. See you soon, guys.